Paul Sarjeant with Global Energy Metals on Skype with us. Paul, how are you?
I'm doing well, thank you.
So I understand Global Energy Metals has partnered with Marquee Resources to advance your Werner Lake project in Ontario. There's a $2.5 million commitment. Can you tell me what the money will be used for?
Yeah, I think primarily the money will be spent on diamond drilling. That's sort of the next phase of the project at this point in time, is to try to dig a little bit deeper into the potential resource area and see if we can expand that resource significantly.
Any kind of milestones that shareholders can expect from the project in the near future?
Well, I think there's sort of two phases, I believe, to the program. There's about $1 million spend that's sort of the first phase of the earn-in requirement by Marquee Resources on the project. And I think that'll be the first phase that we want to try to get through. And again, that will primarily focus on diamond drilling within the current resource area and trying to do some extensions to that zone to depth as well.
You've hired a man named Toby Hughes as chief geologist. What is his background and how does his experiences benefit Werner Lake?
Yeah, Toby's a very well-known geologist in Canada here. He's spent a lot of time on a number of different projects, and just specifically for us, he's actually ran the last drill program at Werner Lake. So he was responsible for about a 7,600-meter program that was done back in 2009-2010 by Puget Ventures. And that experience will go an awful long way to helping us with understanding, you know, what we have on the project and where we want to go with the geology on this. So it's actually a very important hire for Marquee and for us as their partner to have Toby on board and help lead that drill program coming up here this summer.
The tonnage at Werner is smaller than according to the current resource report, even though historically the numbers were much higher. Can you give some clarity to this and how the exploration could grow the resource?
Yeah, I mean, I think it comes down to a regulatory issue. When Canmin Mines, who was the group that took the project through feasibility and were actually went underground on it and actually being mine planning on it, that was prior to the 43-101 requirements that we have to abide by as an exploration group these days, or a mining company. And what they had done, they'd done a lot of drilling high up in the resource area, and then they had put a few holes much deeper down into the area where they thought mineralization would extend, and they were successful in hitting that. But back in 2008-2009, when they were doing that, 1999, when they were doing that kind of work, there wasn't the requirement that we have to meet today from a 43-101 perspective. So they were able to extend mineralization from where they were very confident with their indicated and measured resource, because of what they would call geological continuity, to that kind of depth. We can't do that under 43-101 rules and regulations. So we have to have a lot more drilling to infill those large gaps between where they did the detailed drilling, where some of their deeper intercepts had hit. So, you know, based on the geology, and again, there's only a few holes deep down, but we see no reasons to believe that we can't, do additional work and bring that resource back up into a category that is recognized by 43-101 in the Canadian Institute of Mining.
Paul, thank you so much for the update. Hope to speak to you soon.
My pleasure. Good speaking with you today as well.